The energy. One little me. To a person never see, with a person never see. I say fashy.
Yeah, pray walks out now. Come on, boy, come boy, come boy. Fantastic.
Yeah, I'm going to wear some light.
Okay, I'm sure say it will be a palm wine joint today.
It will be palm wine joint for where I did. You get where people feel just stay, chill out, just chill out. For, now for the house, right?
Okay, so all right.
So now people just stay, chill out. So
that, yeah. Okay, that's good. I like that. So I still have questions for IMCC. So have you seen any young chap play for IMCC?
Yes, I know one, and I can't remember, some 3 weeks ago, I can't remember his name, but I was talking with somebody that day, Taiwo, and then he was like mentioning one IMCC guy, and then I told him that. No, I was mentioning one guy. I said, there's one guy that I'm trying to remember his name. And then the guy was like, what's his name? I said, I don't know. But I described him. He was a spinner. He is a spinner. He's a tall chap.
Yes.
And then he can bat. He has a very good hand-eye coordination. And then he was like, are you sure it's not this guy? And then I said, I don't know the guy's name. So he told me the guy's name, Toluwalase.
Yeah.
So I said yes. Then the next thing I told him after. No. Tayo, forget that one. So the next thing I told him after that was that say GCI they can't carry this guy, and then the guy say they no boy you. So he's one of the person that I
we have a new starlet. His name is Tisho. You've never met him. Young
Tisho?
Boy. Yeah, he's a young chap. He can bowl.
That we don't know. Is it Tisho that
Tisho 777? Anyway, Tisho, I can't see your question, but I've asked three of your questions, right? So calm down, all right? So, okay, is asking, right? You played most of your cricket in Lagos State. Is there any? No, Tisho, I'm not asking that question about Lagos State. I know that's what you asked. So that question is gone. I'm not asking about Lagos State because we already asked about national team captain, Lagos State. Yeah, no. So, okay, is asking, you played most of your cricket in Lagos State. Is there any chance of we seeing you in Anambra State colors? Are you from Anambra, by the way?
I am from Anambra. That's my state of origin.
State of origin, okay.
Yeah.
So are we going to see you in Anambra by any chance? Or are you going to do something about cricket in Anambra?
For me, the main thing about Nigerian cricket, for me, my main belief is to let cricket in Nigeria grow generally.
Yeah.
Okay? Anything that's going to, even if it is Kafanchan, even if it's anywhere, as far as cricket is growing in Nigeria, it's fine by me.
Yeah.
You get so, if it's for me to actually contribute my part, either by advices in any which way, I don't mind. I'll be glad to go and support.
Okay. Yeah, so let's go to GCI. Yeah. I really don't like GCI.
What happened? Collected all your players.
So how did you join GCI?
Okay, so I'll start with the clubs I played for. I started with KC Old Boys. Possibly, I
was. How come everybody started with KC? What happened? Cricket, cricket in Nigeria is like KC.
Let me not be harsh with them. But KC was like it used to be a club that used to be a backup club, like a club where people just they register players then just to back up the other guys that are not going to be around. So I can remember that time I used to go to play for them. I didn't get any game. I think maybe that's where my anger for discipline, my being upset for lack of discipline started from, because a lot of things used to go wrong there then. And then some of them included people, they write list, team list, and someone tells you that he's on his way, and then people that are there don't make the team, and then till the end of the game, and then you know how long cricket takes, man. The end of the game, the person still keeps telling you that I don't mind calling him, I'm on my way. That was really upsetting, you get. And then I got Dele Oshodi, what used to be Dele Oshodi, Akalu Richard. Akalu Richard was really somebody that then, if he tells us do this, if he tells me do this, if he tells my brother do this, we are really after, oh, we want to do it, you get. So he will come, then my mom said, oh, no cricket for a while. And then Akalu came, spoke with her, said okay, and she said okay, and then we'll go to cricket field, and then somebody will call they will be calling one of us, one of the KC guys, and the guy will be like, I'm on my way. The whole of 3 hours, 30 minutes of first innings, he's not going to come. So gradually, I lost interest. My brother was getting a game because I felt he was more of calm-headed. Because for me, as far back as then, I used to tell him, but this doesn't make sense. As far back as then. Then I was 70 years old, and I was telling them this doesn't make sense. So most of the time I said, this boy know they hear, because I used to tell them, you cannot, and then these guys are really big guys, man, big guys. Some of them even wanted to run for governorship. If you can put 1+1, man, you might know one of them. at the end of the day.
Is Femi John listening to this interview?
I hope he is. If he doesn't, we play the tape later. Femi John will call me that time. Say to me, say, don't worry, calm down, everything will be okay. Okay, yeah, I'll tell you that time, me and Femi John, we used to be on loggerheads then, man. Even Odex too, we used to be on loggerheads, because when I say loggerheads, really not for. Odex phone, it was not long ahead. He was still trying to figure me out. So during that time, he was like, he will call me, sit me down, be dragging me up and down like a small boy. And then I was like, Odex, cool down. This thing. You will say, I know where you're coming from, but look at it in my way. I look at it in your way. I say, okay. Oh yeah, you said, look at it in my way again like this. You look at it. Because sometimes I know where I'm coming from used to be a way to let me keep quiet and listen to you. You might not really know, but I know where you're coming from. And then so that I'll just keep going and say, okay, yeah. Mm-hmm. So the second club I played for was Dolphins. I was in Dolphins for about 2 years, then I moved to Pioneers. And then from Pioneers I then moved to FGC Warri. And then from FGC Warri I ended up at GCI.
So will you call GCI home now?
So before now, last season I told GCI I was going to move. Last two seasons, I told GCI I was going to move, because I'm somebody that I don't just leave a club without giving. So I told I told them 3 seasons ago that I was going to move after the next season. So I gave them a year notice that I was going to move. Okay, and then my movement was to go back to FGC Warri. Okay, and then what I told FGC Warri is that If Edges worry, if you guys maintain Division One, I will move with you guys. I will stay. I'll move into you guys. I'll move in with you guys. But Edges worry did not qualify. They relegated.
They relegated.
Yeah, I mean, so I was sure that Mr. Deborah was really happy then, because then I told him beforehand. Even when I was moving to GCI from FGC Warri, I gave FGC Warri, I gave FGC Warri a year notice. Told them that by next year I was going to move, and they said okay, it's fine by then. So most of the time we don't do things out of the blue. We kind of like we do proper planning and the rest.
Okay, so we've mentioned six people right in your list.
Yeah, I think I mentioned six people on my list. Yeah, I mentioned six people. Yeah.
Yeah. So can we have the next three?
All right, the next three I have Okosoya Tayo.
Wow.
Okay. So Okosoya Tayo and then Lake Oyede. Those two that I was contemplating with. Because this now is my middle order. So I ended up going with Okosoya Tayo. I was unfortunate to actually see him play at his peak, but I heard a lot of stories about him. I heard when he was really at his top, at his prime, and then I actually saw him towards the end of his prime, and I saw what he did. He captained me in GCI when I got into GCI. And he was somebody that then the style of play that I kind of play now was the kind of play he used to play then. Because he could actually take teams, he could actually take matches away from teams. And he had a way with scoring runs as far back as then that he had one bat. Like the bat was almost, I think it was older than me. And every time, anytime I see him and that bat, I say, "Ah, this bat is super." As far back as then, so he was really somebody I admired when I was at my my younger stage in cricket. And then the next person is Usita, my brother, and I between him and Sylvester Opey, those are my bets. But for it is too early to actually push Sylvester Okwe. He needs to actually play a lot. Because Sylvester Okwe really needs to play a lot. He has not really played up to the level and as much cricket as my brother has played. And that's why I would go with Osi, because his spin at his peak, when he was at his peak, when he was used to bowl, he finishes his over in two overs. In two overs, sometimes he will finish 10 overs there. He is bowling 11 over. Scorers are shouting, 11 is the 10 over. He has finished over. That's how fast it was, because you don't even know they play him. You don't even know the overs has gone. All of a sudden, you just hear, 20 overs gone. And, 20 overs gone. That's 10-10. 20 overs gone. You get. So, and then his fielding was phenomenal. I can remember there was a time that when I bowl a ball and the ball goes to him like this, I don't even look to see if he has caught it. I know he has caught it. The ball is on the air. I'm celebrating and running. Hey, the wicket is already there. That's how I used to believe in his catches. You get so. And then his fielding, backing up. You know, there are so many principles to fielding, right?
Yeah.
And then there are some principles that they actually taught people. They said, you have to cut the ball. You know how to make a C around the ball. You know, sometimes have to go directly at the ball, but he knew it was like it was already programmed in him. He already knew, this is this is that. And then he knew when to actually approach the ball when it was time. So that's that for us. Let me make a note to praise him. Then the next person is Ogunlola Joshua. Ogunlola Joshua, like Onikoyi, is another person that if tomorrow, in 20 years' time, I'm calling my first 11, he will still appear. Okolola Joshua is somebody that you just take the ball, one run to win, last over, you throw the ball to him, he will tell you this is what I'm going to do, and he will do it.
Wow.
Is you don't need to he you don't he, and he doesn't try to be fantastic. He just does the basic thing. Pa pa pa, everything is down. He doesn't need to be fantastic. He doesn't do anything fantastic. Before you know it, he's giving you results. Even when you feel everything is down, the way he makes people believe. There are some times that you might want to lose the game. And then, okay, I remember, I'll give you an instance. When we were playing against Mozambique in 2008, so those guys, we scored 108 runs. And then it's a 50 overs game. In like 15 overs, these guys were already on 50 or something, or 10 overs, they're already on 50. Mm. And then Joshua was bowling. Cheye and this guy opened bowling. And then Wale Ade opened bowling. And then Cheye took for 1 wicket. They've taken 2 wickets. And then these Mozambique guys were kind of like making fun of us because the game was already in their hands. Come on, it was just. They were constantly scoring 200 in the games. So this 108 was nothing really for them. And then Joshua picked the ball. And we went for dinner. We went to get lunch because we finished the game early. So they entered immediately. So after they got 50 something, we went to get lunch. And then we came back. And then when we are having our lunch, we discussed, okay, let's give Joshua a ball. And then Joshua wrapped these guys up. As at maybe like 15 overs, they're on 50 something. As at the 20 something overs, these guys were on 8 wickets down. And they were still scoring runs though. And then all of a sudden, most people in this place, like most people in my list I have really memorable experiences with them in cricket. And then before you knew it like this, we wrapped these guys up and we won the game. That was what took us to the UK. That was what took us to the UK in 2008 for the first time.
Wow.
So Joshua is my number Joshua. 8.
Yeah.
My number 9, sorry. So that's my number 9.
Yeah, so number nine. Okay. No. I have a question about young cricketers for you.
Okay.
Now, this one, I know one story. Sharp, sharp. Three things you will advise a young cricketer.
For me, I'll tell you, practice hard. Practice. Believe in yourself. Even if you feel you know you are worth the team and you still get dropped, just keep pushing.
Mm.
When you're good, you're good. If you're good, you're good. You can only be delayed.
Mm.
And then, but that practicing area is the most important thing. It's one of the most important
things. Yeah.
A lot of us,
I've heard somebody say something before that if you can play 120 balls per day, it's practice. The ball bats 120 balls per day, and
you used to tell a lot of cricket. And for me, I would say I'm not one of the best cricketers, but my fitness used to be as far back as they used to be top notch. Mm. So, and then I noticed that when I'm very fit, I play very well. You get when I'm not fit, I play well still, but. Mm-hmm. I'm limited. People outside will say, "Oh, you still scored runs." So, but I know deep down that if I was fit, I would have scored better. You get fitness has a way to when you are aligning to the ball. You get when you are aligning to the ball, when you're not fit, your alignment is not totally correct. You might score the runs, you might get the boundaries, but deep down, your alignment is not correct. And some people have really not experienced it. Experienced the fitness level. And the non-fitness level to actually know when you get. So they've not really experienced it to know how it is.
Thank you, Stanley, for summarizing that for us. I've just been there. So for young cricketers watching, practice hard, study hard, and don't ever give up. That's what he's saying. So let's go back to your top 11. Last two. Not too much story this time around.
Okay. Akolade Said.
Said.
Like I told you, big man. Like I told you, these are most of the people on my list are people that when I'm going to play, I think of how I will survive as a batsman, as a bowler. I'll think of how I'm going to remove them. So Akolade Said is one of them on my list. And then
you think about how you last, play against him.
Yes, how I'll survive. So what I usually do is I'll see you through. The moment I see you through, do anything once I see you through, and then the other people like this. You just
so
like
is that,
you.
Is that respecting the bowler of what he can do?
When you say see through, you get. When I say see through, anybody that knows me will tell you that if Chimeze says see through, it doesn't mean that he's good at it. I can tell you that, at the fair, the next ball you go, you put it at this one place I used to, in me, by default, I go after that ball. I don't know how I do it, but even if you tell me, say, block ball, the minute the ball goes there, I'm swinging at it. I'll be going with an elbow and I'll swing at it. You get? So, when I say I'm respecting, it's like, at the back of my mind, I say, don't try anything rash, irrational. Mm-hmm. Don't try anything irrational. That's what I mean. That's what I mean by seeing you through. You get?
It doesn't mean they're setting you up. Yeah.
I'll go after you. Uh-huh. And then the last person was between Thomas Aruno, that's pumping. You might not know him, but you might have heard of him. Thomas Aruno. Yes. And Apollarin. My list was supposed to have Thomas Aruno first. But Apollarin is somebody that I've really played against him. I've played against him, and for me now, I don't think he is in his peak, and he's not in his topmost fitness level, and what he is doing with the ball is mad. But for now, I will still say it's still too early to put him in the list. He should still take his time.
So you go with Aruna.
I'll still go with Aruna.
Okay, so there is one more person that you can name, and this is your top man. Who would it be?
Yes, my top man. There are plenty on the list. There are plenty. But the person I'll go with is this guy, Zikman. Zikman.
Who? Okay.
Yeah, Zik Okwe.
Okay.
Yeah, he's our man.
Okay, so two more questions from me, then I will take one from anyone who's got question. The first question for me would be, who would you say is your best cricket captain?
My best cricket captain. Okay. I hope you still have time.
Name one. We don't have time.
So Okay, we don't have time. Okay, my best cricket captain, I would go with Wale Adeo.
Wale Adeo.
Yeah, I'll go with Wale Adeo.
Okay. So there is a question that had gone through, and I just remembered now. What's your memorable cricket game? Most memorable cricket game?
My most memorable cricket game. I have about three. I will mention them briefly. Against Mozambique. I've mentioned one already.
Yeah.
The one against Mozambique. I'll mention the one in Botswana.
Okay.
Yes. My brother mentioned it in his interview. So it had to do with them. It had to do with we just went in there. I had a video of it. I don't know how the thing got missing. I had a video of the whole tournament, of the whole match. We just went there to ourselves. We are all making noise. We are all reducing. We are just celebrating. We knew we are out of tournaments. But we just wanted to make sure that we caned these guys. And then we just kept on swinging our bats. We played unconventional cricket. We are not all about court results. You get. So that's the second one. And then the last game was in Nigeria. Is in Nigeria. I cannot mention it as I'm not conventional Nigeria. So it was against Ibeju. And there was a question that's asked somebody time, who is your toughest opposition? My toughest opposition used to be in Nigeria, I used to be a veteran. Those are the guys that whenever I'm going to play, I used to think about how I'm going to survive, how I'm going to do this. And then the moment I get going. So the last one was that game, those guys, it's 190 something.
This against DCI, I mean?
Yeah. Yes, against DCI. It's called 190 something. I think it was then, that was when I was the captain in Nigeria. Yeah. So a lot of people came to watch. And I used to have somebody that, some people that used to, then they used to say, this guy, they come to watch me. After they finish watching me, they give me money. Now, so they become what they, even if I score on this guy, just say, I think I like the way they, even when I edge more, say, I like the way edge more. So anyway, so I then, so during that time, they scored 100 and something. In 4 overs, they've taken 3 wickets or 4 wickets. So I came in, and we are like, maybe like 8 or 9 runs. I came in. So what I did, and they played their 50 overs as I came in, I was batting with somebody, one guy. I can't remember the person. So I was batting with him. I then told him that, CEO, me, I know, say, the chances of losing, if it was a bet now, our odds would not reduce. Let's just stay increase. Let them at least suffer small as we take all our 50 overs and they no come out. Let them suffer small. Play. That guy went out before you know my brother came in. Play. We kept on playing. And then I ended up scoring 100 in that game. No, 90-something. Like 90-something in that game. My brother scored 50-something before he went out. And we won the game. So that was one of my most memorable games. That game, the one that I actually... There are other games that I've scored bigger. This game was like a no game. Actually, that game, I came out, I saw the video where they snapped me. Somebody snapped the photo. I was crying. They were snapping me. I was just covering my face that you should not snap me. That's how crazy I used to be. That's how crazy personality is. So imagine somebody that can come out crying and then somebody then joke about the game with me. I take the person on to see you get. That means you don't know what the game is about.
Yeah. So we have challenges with cricket in Nigeria administration wise. Maybe now things are getting a little bit better. So if you are going to choose 3 people, if you have the power to choose 3 people, right? To become the NCF president and you think they can lead to take cricket to the next level, who would it be?
Okay. I can just call 3 random people, but that 3 random people is not going to make a lot of sense for me. I know why. Because if you're the
don't call 3 random people, people you have watched.
3 good people that actually trust. But if you call 3 people up there and then people that are working under them, I'm not really there. It's still gonna be the same thing. But I will call one. I will call the first person. He has been running it for a while. That's Uyi. The second person I'm gonna call is really not about the running, but he needs to be somewhere at the top 2 or top 3. Because where he's what these 2 of them. Where what they say is going to be very, very relevant is between is Tayo and Endurance. Tayo Showole, Endurance of them. And then those are the 2 people. Okay. Any of them, they can toss a coin and pick one of them inside there. 2 of them have almost similar attributes. Then the last person, Mr. Debolo Ogunsina and Oladi, that has to do with financial and management area. But people that are going to actually put it in implementation between Endurance. And this is so. I will not that I'm tipping them for the NCF president. It's not. It's so that they can. There are things that those guys they see it. You get the NCF president for me. The name, the word, the president is just like it's just they're just going to be there. Figurehead. People that are going to be running it is really what me I'm after because you can just be there.
Yeah, the reason why I'm asking this question is because right there has to be an inspiration. See, no matter what, you call all the good guys below them. If the guy on the on top does not have any inspiration, does not have anything to add, there won't be any direction below.
Yes, there will be any direction. Okay, if he doesn't have anything to add. So if he adds it, for example, and then pushes it down, and they don't implement it, that's another thing.
No, so that's so, so that's the mistake you are making, right? People who are inspirational and people who know what to do, right, know the people to employ.
Okay.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. So that's the way it works. They know the people to employ, the people to bring in, you know. Do you understand? Or they know how to make the people below to work.
To work.
Yes.
All right.
But without that,
okay.
Yeah, those are the attributes of good people. And that's the attribute you've seen in Ogunshino. He can't play cricket. He knows, he understands the administration of cricket and those things, and he makes it happen within within the club. All right. I'm waiting for one more question from anyone, if you've got a question. But honestly speaking, I've enjoyed speaking with you. I totally understand you. You're not the typical Niger guy. You want to break boundaries. You want to do things, you know, the way you feel like doing it at that point, and which is good. And you want to express yourself. And sometimes in games, right, you need to express yourself, isn't it? Yes. Who do we have? Question. And there's no more question. So I will leave you with this. I'll ask you to say this. If you were to advise IMCC, what will you tell us?
I've really been most of your games, I used to go and watch it. I used to watch it because of recent, where I stay in Lagos, is around where you guys usually play. So sometimes I just stroll down on my spare time and go watch your games. So what I would just say is, most of you guys, I like the passion you guys are putting into cricket. Okay. I like that. This is something that we're looking at the national level. Those at the national level are doing, or they are doing. I know most of you guys are still startup section. It's a startup set of young generations in cricket. I hope you guys just keep going and you guys don't relent. You guys shouldn't just get discouraged, because trust me, there will be a state that you guys will be discouraged. I mean, I know that. You guys be like, oh, we are bringing teams and GCI is taking them and the rest of them. So it's something that you guys should relax.
We should first blow up GCI before
you guys just don't relent. Just guys, just still keep pushing it. At the end of the day, I know that you guys' vision for cricket in Nigeria is something that a lot of other clubs, a lot of other teams, a lot of other schools we reckon with in the long run.
All right. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Chimeze. Thank you for coming. We really, really appreciate this. It was fun all the way from 0 to 100. It took us all the way. I love your stories and all that. Really appreciate this. So we're going to save this video and we're going to play back to people all the time and share with the young ones. They can listen, especially the practice hard, study the game hard, and don't give up, right? Yes, so thank you very much. Thank you for your time.
Yeah, welcome.
Happy to see you. Yeah, bye.
Yeah.